Let me get out of the way. I don't want to block.
All right, Leo. You were a busy man this year. 5 times. Yeah. Is that the way you like it? I mean, you know, when you started this year, did you think you were going to fight 5 times, even after winning a world title?
I thought it was going to be like every 3 months or every 4 months. But for me, I'm happy. Huh? I like fighting sooner. I think it's a better opportunity for me, and it's for the fans too. They get to know me more, and give them good shows.
Does it take a toll, the training camp after training camp? You know, the fight with Malinga, you dominated it, but it's 12, you know, it was 12 rounds. There's wear and tear there. You absolutely dominated Eric Morrell. But your last fight was tough. I mean, you were in there with the guy who wasn't as well known as an Eric Morrell, but he came to fight.
Yeah, no.
And you guys gave you put more punishment on him, but he's fighting back and he's landing punches on you as well. And I remember there was some bruising on your face and everything.
Yeah.
Is there ever a little thing in the back of your mind saying, yeah, I'd like to take a vacation and then go right into the holidays and chill out, and then, you know, does that ever enter your mind? Or?
Yeah. It entered after this one, but since they offered me the fight in December, I was like, yeah, why not? I want to finish the year in December, and then, because after that fight, in December is going to be Christmas, so I was like, well, now I'll take the week off. Because if that would have been the last one, maybe I would have fought maybe in January or February. But this one after December, now I could take like 2-3 weeks off and spend time with my family and enjoy Christmas and New Year. So, that's why I took it.
What's your secret to maintaining weight? Because every time I see you, it looks like you lost 10 pounds.
Yeah, no, yes, stay in the gym. I really take that much off. My dad always tell me that to be ready, because they could call me any minute. So, and that's what I do. I'm always in the gym. If I'm in the gym, sometimes I don't feel comfortable. I feel like I'm not doing right by staying out of the gym. That's why I'm always in the gym. Even if I'm not working that hard, I'm still right there, yes, staying in shape. And yeah, because that's what I like doing. And I'm only always in the gym.
You're fighting on CBS. Do you know what that means? Like how big that is?
Yeah, I know. At first, I didn't really realize how big it was, but now there's gonna be like millions of people watching, and that's what I want. I want the people to see me and to become fans, and hopefully they like how I fight and they keep on following me.
The same day, Amir Khan is fighting Carlos Molina. Break down that fight.
Oh, I think that's a really good fight too. Right then, both of them. I know Carlos Molina. I trained with him in the gym before, and I see how hard he works and everything, and I think it's going to be a really good fight for both of them.
You think he can spring the upset? I know he's a big underdog, but he has what it takes?
Yeah, if he gets caught with a good shot and he pressures, like he has to do pressure, I think he could bring the upset, yeah.
You think he has the power to test that chin?
Yeah, I think he does, because I seen him sparring and he has some really good, strong punches. I seen sparring and he's the other guys, and he said their head was like really like, yeah, so I think he does have the power to knock him out.
He's like you. He comes from a fighting family.
Yeah, yeah.
His brother's box. Yeah. He's the oldest brother. You're the youngest brother. What does it, is that an advantage for you, having had older brothers who are also professionals?
Yeah, it's an advantage because I learned from the mistakes that they did and from the good things they did too. So they give me advice and they tell me what worked for them and what didn't work for them. So I think it's really good that to have older brothers. They could talk to you and go through their experiences.
Leo, when you have the belt, everybody's gunning for you. Everybody wants your belt. How do you stay motivated? How do you stay? Because they're coming hungry. They want to knock your head off.
Yeah, well, that gives me more motivation because I know that they want to take the belt. So and for me to know that, it gives me motivation to train harder because it wasn't easy winning that belt. So, and for them to want to take it that easily, it's not going to happen. I'm going to make them work for it. I'm going to give them a good war, and it's going to be, they have to go through hell first to beat me.
Since the knockout of Marquez over Pacquiao this weekend, every fighter that I talk to can't wait to fight. That fight pumped them up.
Yeah.
That happened to you too when you saw it?
The truth, I didn't really watch that fight because I was going through an interview. So while I was going, the fight was happening. But when I got there, I saw the knockout, but yeah, I didn't really get to see it. So that's why I didn't. Yeah, maybe not.
What would you tell your fans in LA about your fight Saturday? I think if they donate a toy, they can watch it for free, right?
Yeah, I think not. I think they could even go for free.
His fight is free, and if you bring a toy that's still wrapped during the package, valued at $20 or more, you get a ticket for the Khan Molina. Two tickets for the Khan Molina fight.
What do you think about that?
Well, I think that's really good because that way more people could come and they support me. And that's why I want for fans to come and support me, and hopefully I get more fans and they like my performance that night, because I trained really hard for them and to give them a good show, and that's what they're gonna get.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Good luck. There you have it, Leo Santa Cruz, world champion. He's fighting December 15th at the LA Sports Arena. As you heard, entrance is free. FitYesNewsReporting.com. I'm Melissa, back reporting.